In this video, we'll show you how to implement a professional web dashboard on the XMC7 microcontroller. Start by getting the kit XMC72 EVK development board and connecting it to both your Ethernet network and your workstation. Next, go to mongos.ws and click on the big blue button. This opens the interactive web dashboard builder. Select Create New Project and click Next. Choose an output directory. Select the kit XMC72 EVK board and modus IDE, then click Next again. Choose the default dashboard, click Next, and then click Finish. You now have a default dashboard that we can modify. Click the Generate button. The wizard will now generate a project in the selected output directory. Open modus IDE and import the generated project. Go to File Import, Import Existing Project, choose the output directory, wait a few seconds, and there it is. Click the Build button. The project should build with no errors. Start a serial console to view debug logs. Next, open the Modus Flashing tool. Select the kit XMC72 EVK board and choose the firmware file located at build appkit xmc7 evk debug hex file. Click Connect, then Program to flash the firmware. Now you'll see debug logs, including the IP address assigned to your board by DHCP. You're watching the Mongoose channel. Mongoose is a network stack for embedded devices with just two files, mongoose.c and mongoose.h. Yes, it includes TLS too. If you're building a professional web UI dashboard for your device or need to connect to an MQTT server, click the link below this video. Open the IP address in your browser, log in with admin, and you'll see the same dashboard we created earlier, now being served directly from the device. Clicking the LED controls doesn't do anything yet. That's because by default, these controls are connected to default callback functions that do nothing. To make them functional, we'll add our own custom callbacks and connect the controls to the actual hardware. The LED panel uses two callback functions, one to read the LED states and one to write them. Open main.c and add two functions, mySetLEDs and mygetLEDs. After Mongoose init, add a call to Mongoose set HTTP handlers to tell Mongoose to use our custom callbacks instead of the default ones. Rebuild and reflash the firmware. Open the IP address in your browser again, and now you can toggle the real LEDs using your dashboard. Congratulations! Hit like and subscribe if you found this video useful. See you in the next one.